Disclaimer, I do not own any rights to any content, videos, research, music, unless it is of my own creation. Everything is for entertainment and commentary purposes. All information is of my own opinion or are alleged until factual evidence has been presented. Cue the music. Hey, everyone. Welcome back to another episode from your girl, All Things CC. Here is my take today. It's going to probably be a little short video. I'm just going to get on here and give you guys some quick reports. And I'm going to dive into the main topic. And it is regarding Mea Culpa, the Tyler Perry movie that was on Netflix. And I have some good takeaways. And I have one major thing that really just pissed me off. Stick to them. It's the quick report. Ooh, I like quickies. Okay, so everybody have heard by now that Portia and Simon are headed for divorce. Portia decided she was going to file for divorce after hearing about the allegations against her husband Simon and his deportation allegations and him just being a fraud. Now, is this the real reason why Portia is coming back to Real Housewives of Atlanta? So that she can break away from him? This is another case of God don't bless no mess. But I'm going to keep my ear to the TV so I can keep an update on this situation. Kelly Rowland quickly got the interviewer together after asking her about any of Beyonce's projects while she's on the road promoting her new movie from Netflix from Tyler Perry Productions called Mea Culpa. And she pretty much told them, let's not talk about her. I'm here to talk about this. Kelly is tired of y'all and this Beyonce bullshit, okay? And I am too. Kelly has made a name for herself out of Destiny's Child, and she is her own woman doing her own thing. So give her the respect that she is due. Y'all always do that. Ask her about Beyonce like she her keeper or something. Okay, so a lot of people are suggesting that Miss Risa Tisa might be lying about the whole situation. It could be just one big old thing just to get views and likes and everything like that. Do y'all think that this was all made up? Or do y'all think this is some real shit that happened to her? Like, she was very believable, but I don't put nothing past nobody on social media. Okay, you guys, so that is it for the quick report. Y'all let me know what y'all think. Put y'all comments down in the comment section. I'm not going to speak too long. We're about to go on ahead and get into this, my review or my recap of the Mea Culpa movie and what I think. And I just want to say the overall movie, I'm giving it 6.5. As we all know, the beautiful Kelly Rowland is the main character in this movie. And I thought she did a pretty good job. I felt like she embodied her character as best as she could. Now, I will say that the fight scene at the end, I think she could have did a little bit better. But that's just my opinion. Storyline is not too far from Tyler Perry's writing history. You know, we got the movies where you got the black woman scorned, you got the movies where you got the black woman cheating on her husband, and you know, it's still the same type of situation. And at this point, his movies are coming very predictable. There's nothing to the imagination with his movies anymore. And I like Tyler Perry. I really, really do, because I think he's a creative person. But I just feel like his storylines are too similar in one way or another. Okay? When I heard about this movie coming out with Kelly Rowland, I was like, okay, this is different. You know, he's never had any type of celebrity from a Destiny Child group. This is his first time having Kelly Rowland out of Destiny's Child. And I was a little confused at first of why her, why she was the casting character for the main character. But I knew that it was a great marketing move as well, because Kelly Rowland brings in those numbers. She is part of Destiny's Child history. She is royalty. She's going to bring in them numbers. Everybody loves Kelly Rowland. Everybody loves Kelly Rowland. That's my girl. Like I said, her acting, she did as good as she could. Best as she could. The best thing about her character is she was dialed up to the nines. Her makeup was on fleek. Her hair was on fleek. Every outfit that she had on was like top tier. Like, she looked fucking good, okay? And I knew that she was going to bring life to the character, because she's just a genuine person and she's a believable person. And the personality that she brought with it, I can tell that the personality of the character, minus the cheating part, she has that same type of personality, that strong, stand on boundaries. Like, that's her personality in real life. Again, minus the cheating. So that was the best thing that I liked about the movie as far as her character. The main guy character, his name is Savante, and I've never seen him or heard of him. But baby, if that ain't a fine chocolate little man, listen, that is a fine man right there. Tyler Perry know how to pick the men. Y'all take that however y'all want to take it. But when it comes to his movies, he knows how to pick the men. And this man is fine. And he played the part very, very well. Very, very well. Like, I was very intrigued about his character. Now, I'm going to give y'all the best part of the movie. The best part of the movie was the sex scene. My goodness. My goodness. If that wasn't some real live work of art, I would have never thought to be having sex in paint. Like, that just did something to me, y'all. I don't know about y'all, but that did something to me. And I'm like, that is some exotic, romantic shit right there. Okay? Like, one of the best sex scenes I have seen since Set It Off with Stoney and Blair Underwood. Okay? This, by far, is one of the best sex scenes I have ever seen. Tyler Perry did his big one on that. He did his big one on that. Now, let's go back a little bit. And I want to go back to the character of her husband. Her husband apparently lost his job because he was getting high on his own supply. I think he was an anesthesiologist or something like that. But he was getting high on his own supply. He had to go to rehab. He had to go to therapy and all that type of stuff. And because he lost his job, Mia had to come in and help take care of the household financially, physically, mentally, because he dropped the ball as the head of the household. And I can sense right there, the personalities didn't even match. I could tell that he wasn't a leader. And by her personality being so strong, it kind of overpowered his. But because she knew that she was married, a lot of stuff she did decide to, you know, calm it down a little bit because she's married. But since he has been unemployed and she has been doing everything on her own, that attitude has changed. And she's getting that mentality like, you can't tell me what to do about nothing. Because you ain't paying the bills. You ain't the head of the household. So the roles have reversed. And now she feels like, you can't tell me shit. I can do what I want to do now. You're not even a man in my eyes. And things of that nature. The husband, I did not like him at all. He came off as so weak. So weak. Even amongst his brother and his mother, he was the weakest link. And they can manipulate him to do whatever it is that they wanted him to do. He was going to do it. He was a true mama's boy to the T. And it is in real life. Is men who will still put their mother first. They will still do it. And that causes problems within the marriage. Now, it was only two black females, and everybody else was not of non-color, you know. And I'm going to tell y'all the biggest thing that made me dislike this whole movie and the reason why I rated it a 6.5. Because there seems to always be in Tyler Perry's movies where the black woman is being degraded and disrespected in front of other people of color. So what I'm saying is her husband's mother had no respect for her at all. The way she talked to her in front of her husband was so disgusting. And the way his brother talked to his wife, which was the other black woman, was disgusting. And they sat there and let them talk to them any kind of way, like they were some damn lap dogs. I did not appreciate that. Because here it is, you have a woman who is strong, well-minded, who is a lawyer of her own law firm, doing hella well. She's strong. But then when it comes to her husband and his family, she ain't got a backbone. She ain't got a backbone to say, I don't like the way your mama talking to me. Check your mama. Like, she didn't have a backbone to say any of that. And I just found that to be so weird. So disappointing. In this sense, for these two women, black women, the quote from Malcolm X rings true. Black women are the most to be disrespected, not protected. You know what I'm saying? You get where I'm going, right? That's how I seen that. And I swear, if I was able to take my hand and put it through the TV screen, I would have smacked the crap out of that mama all which types of ways. Because the way that she was disrespectful, who? Kelly Rowland's character was better than me. She better than me. Because at that moment, I would have told him, you got to choose. It's either your mama or it's me. And then the fact that he was scared to even tell his family that he lost his job and he was going to rehab and stuff. She married a beta male, which is already a recipe for disaster. A beta male who seemed to not be able to think for himself, make rational decisions, and pretty much does everything that his family and his mother wants him to do. And not to mention, he sold her piano to get his quote unquote sick mother a beautiful watch for her birthday. Are you shitting me? Are you shitting me? Y'all, the level of disrespect for Mia out of this world. No wonder she cheated. She can't depend on her husband. She can't depend on her family, her in-laws. Like, her back is against the wall. She ain't got nobody to really talk to besides the other black woman, but she's so like a dang on puppy dog, she can't hold water. She can't hold water. And that's sad. But I will say at the end, they did come together. They did try to come together to stop the in-laws, because they realized that they were the ones behind the whole scheme, the whole plot of the whole damn movie. Y'all. This movie, it was decent. I'm not going to say it was horrible. It was decent. Would I watch it again? Yeah, I'll watch it again because I like Kelly. And I like the production of it. I like the quality of the film. But I do think the storyline is redundant. And I think that Tyler needs to bring on new writers that have a different vision. I need Tyler Perry for the next couple of films that he decides to do. He needs to really make sure that he is not portraying black women as the victims, the angry black, or the no backbone. Like, we need a different type of character for our black woman, Tyler. You can have a good movie with a black woman in it that is a lawyer, that is strong, is independent, and she means business, and she still is successful in her own right, and she still has a successful marriage, family. You can still have that. But all it seems is you want these black women to cheat, be angry, commit crimes. Like, it's becoming a stigma for a black woman. And actually, it's been a stigma for a long time for black women when it came to Tyler Perry and his movies. Oh, and I can't forget alcoholics and, you know, stuff like that. Can't get those stereotypes. And don't get me wrong, I appreciate him catering to the black community and providing black people with job opportunities. Kudos to him for that. But we gotta change this narrative. We got to change the narrative. I did not like the way that those nine people of color were just talking to those black women the way that they were. Disgusting. I almost wanted to turn the damn movie off. So, y'all, I am done with my review. Let me know what y'all think in the comment section. Do y'all agree with me? Do y'all understand what I'm trying to say? What did y'all take away from the movie? Do y'all think that he needs to stop making movies like this? What do y'all think Tyler Perry needs to do to elevate his craft? Yeah, he's a billionaire and everything in his own right, but that still does not mean that he does not have room to grow and get better. It's almost like he's scared to take that leap because he know that the standard and the norm has always gotten him money. So y'all let me know what y'all think. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Thank you to the new subscribers. I will be following new subscribers back as soon as I can. Let's help push me to get to 500 subscribers and to 1,000 subscribers. Let's keep that going. The more I get subscribers, the more I'm going to put out content. So yeah, y'all let me know what y'all think of this episode. Let's have a conversation. And you know what? I chatted up with you guys on the next episode. Later.